How's it going, everyone? BrotalSimes here, and today I'm going to be answering some noobs' questions about the PS4 Jailbreak 9.00, so let's get started. Question number one. I'm probably the most asked question on the internet since the 9.00 Jailbreak came out. I have PS4 version 9.03. Can I downgrade it to 9.00 and then Jailbreak? No. Absolutely not. There is no way to downgrade any PS4 version to a lower version. So you're better off selling that console and go get yourself a 9.00 PS4, because 99% of the PS4s that are being sold now are 9.00, and you have a great chance in finding a 9.00 PS4. Question number two. I have many games on my PS4. If I update to 9.00, will the PS4 wipe all my games? Will the PS4 factory reset and I have to download these games and install them again? Will my saves disappear? Will everything disappear if I update to 9.00? No, none of that is gonna happen. Your games will remain intact. Your games will still be there, and even your save data will remain there, and nothing's gonna happen to your games or saves. So the only thing that's gonna change is the PS4's firmware version. So don't worry about that. None of your games are gonna disappear, and nothing's gonna happen to your PS4 if you update to 9.00. Question number three. Do I have to re-enable the Jailbreak every time I restart the console? Yes, like all the previous Jailbreaks that we had since 1.76 up till 7.55, you have to go to the web browser and enable the Jailbreak every time you reboot the console. So I really don't know why people are confused about this. Maybe because it's a different bug that requires a USB drive, and people are like, maybe if I keep the USB stick there in the PS4 and reboot, then I don't have to enable the Jailbreak. No, it doesn't work that way. The Jailbreak has to be activated every time you restart the console. The only way for you to not re-enable the Jailbreak is to put the PS4 in rest mode. And since we have Goldhand, and Goldhand supports rest mode, then you're better off using rest mode. That, or you can wait for a custom firmware, which may not happen till like 3, 4, or 5 years from now, and that's probably the only way for us to not re-enable the Jailbreak, a custom firmware. So that is not gonna happen for years, so you're better off using rest mode for now. Question number four. I sent update 9.00 to a USB stick, but when I try to update the PS4, it gives me this error, cannot connect to the server. What this means is that you have the internet turned on and you have Al-Azif's DNS. And when the internet is turned on, the PS4 ignores the update that you have on your USB stick and goes to the server and looks for the newest and latest firmware to install it. And if it can't connect to the servers, it will give you this error. So make sure that you turn off the internet and go and try again, and it will show you the update that you have on your USB drive. Question number five. I downloaded and installed a game, but when I try to run it, it tells me to go to the store to purchase this product, and the padlock is still there. What you did is that you downloaded and installed an official package and not a fake package. In other words, you did not download the cracked game. You downloaded the legit copy and it will not work. So what you have to do is delete that package and go and download the fake package. How do you know if it's a fake package or an official package? Well, there is the package viewer application for PC, and there is also PS4 Explorer, a homebrew app for PS4. You can go to the USB drive and click on it one time with X, and it's going to tell you on the top if it's an official or a fake package. Question number six. I'm trying to install a game update, but I'm getting error CE36244-9. Even though I have the full game installed on my PS4 and the update has the same region code as the full game that I have on my PS4. Well, what you have here is an update file that was dumped from another disk different than the full game that you have on your PS4. Even though it has the same region code, but the disks are different. So what you have to do is use the Duxa patch repackager to marry this update file to the full game. But remember, it will only work if both the game and the update have the same region code. So for example, if you have Bloodborne CUSA 03173, the update file should be CUSA 03173, and that's how it works. Number 7. I'm trying to send a game to my USB stick, but it's telling me that the file is too large for the destination file system. That means that your USB drive has been formatted with the FAT32 system that does not support files larger than 4 GB. So what you have to do is format it to the XFAT system, and you can copy games as large and as big as you can. So format that USB drive that you have to XFAT. Question number 8. I found a PS4 game that says required firmware 5.05 or 6.72. Will it work on 9.00? Yes, it will, because you have the superior version. Basically, what those required firmwares means is that the minimum firmware version should be 5.05. So if you have 9.00, you're like more than qualified to run this game. So this is how it works. Any PS4 game that you can find and download on the internet right now works on 9.00. So there is no worries there. Go ahead and download that game. 9. If I jailbreak my PS4, can I play online? No, you cannot play online and you cannot connect to the PlayStation Store. Number 10. I used Disk Imager to write that xfathacks.image jailbreak to my USB drive. Can I still use my USB drive to send games to it or send saves to it from the PS4? No, you can't, because the disk will be write protected and will be approximately 4 MB size, so you cannot send anything to it. So I really recommend that you find a small USB drive, like 1 GB or 4 GB, and then use it only for jailbreaking the PS4. Don't write that xfathacks image to an external hard drive that is like 1 TB or 3 TB. Just use a small USB flash drive. Number 11. I flashed that jailbreak image to a USB drive, but when I plug it into the PS4 to jailbreak it, the screen goes black and then the PS4 crashes, or I receive no notifications. That's because your USB drive is 3.1, and what you need to use is a 2.0 USB drive or a 3.0 USB drive. So try different USB sticks and don't ever use 3.1 USB sticks. Number 12. How do I disable system updates? Well, to do that, you need to do 3 things. Well, 2 actually, and the third is kind of optional. First of all, you need to go to the PS4 system settings and go to the automatic downloads and make sure that everything in here is unchecked. After that, you need to add LSZIF DNS to your internet settings. And finally, you need to go to a 9.00 host and make sure that it has the disable updates payload in it. And every time you activate the jailbreak, come here and click on disable updates just to make sure that updates are disabled. Number 13. What are the best hosts for jailbreak 9.00? Here are my top 5 hosts. Al-Azif's host, GamerHack, DarkModder, HackoRifo or PS4 Exploit, and finally Stairskovi's host. Question number 14. I have PS4 version 7.55 or 7.02. Should I update to 9.00? Yes, definitely. 100% you should update to 9.00 because it's much, much more stable and you will say goodbye to those. There's not enough free system memory messages. You can say goodbye to those because you will rarely see them. Also, you won't have to worry about backports and you don't have to wait for them and deal with their issues. This backport doesn't work, that backport works. You won't have to worry about that because you will be playing games natively on 9.00. So yes, update, especially if you're on 7.55 or 7.02. Number 15, is there a way, any way, to jailbreak PS4 version 9.00 without a USB drive? No, absolutely not. And there is no host to enable the jailbreak without a USB drive. Maybe in the future, in the coming months, there will be a method somehow, but right now there is no other method to jailbreak PS4 9.00 without a USB drive. Speaking of the USB drive, there is something that I should have mentioned in the beginning, which is removing the USB stick right after getting that notification that says USB device is not supported. So when you get that notification, remove the USB stick and then click OK, and you should get that gold hand loaded notification. So if you don't remove the USB drive and then you restart the console, you will corrupt the PS4's memory and then you will get tons of glitches and errors. And to fix that, a restart should be enough. But if that does not work and you keep getting glitches and errors, then you may end up reinstalling the entire operating system. So always remove the USB drive when you get that notification that the USB drive is unsupported. Number 16. I have PS4 version 8.00, 01, 8.03, 8.50, 8.52. Where can I go to jailbreak my PS4? You cannot, because there is no jailbreak for the mentioned versions. What you have to do is update to 9.00 and then jailbreak, because there's going to be a long time and probably there will never be a jailbreak for those mentioned versions, because we've seen this before where the jailbreak skips many versions and it becomes available on the newest version. So we've seen that before, and this is probably the case again. So 9.00 is great, update to it, and jailbreak. Number 17. Do I need to use the internet every time I want to activate the jailbreak? No, you don't have to, because most websites have the caching option. So you can pick up a host, then cache it, and then you can use it offline whenever you like. So yeah, there is no need for internet when you cache the website. And most hosts will cache themselves automatically when you visit them. So no worries there. You can cache the website and then go to the internet and turn it off from there. And you can even remove the Ethernet cable or change the password of your Wi-Fi. So no worries there. I think this concludes it. This is the end of the video. These questions that I just thought of them from the top of my head and then I just answered them. So yeah, I hope you had some questions answered in this video, and I will see you soon. Take care.